Happy talk, keep talking, happy talk. Talk about things you like to do. You got to have a dream. If you don't have a dream, how you gonna have a dream come true?
In the summer of 2001, a couple musicians and myself took upon the task of recreating Victoria's history of rock and roll music from 1956 to 1985. Those musicians were Ken Sherwood and Ross Damude, who are both unfortunately not able to be with us today. We agreed to do this as an accurate recreation of the development of the art of contemporary music in Victoria through four decades. It was and is our quest to tell a story. A story that we all knew and spoke about amongst ourselves, a story of a small Canadian city on an island in the West Coast that was fertile ground for the creation of music. A place where it was revered for its beautiful forests, the smell of the ocean, and the spirit of its people. A place where a person of any ability or desire could come and fulfill a dream to become a musician. But not just any musician, as Victoria could, did, and does make you better or the best musician by any standard, anywhere in the world. A place where even great musicians come hoping to become even greater because of its surroundings and the peace amongst its fellow men and women who pursue the art of music. In the year 2005, the Royal City Music Project began its national and international campaigns. We set out to tell all that would listen that Victoria, British Columbia is the best place in the world to make music. Do we all agree? Absolutely. No one or two or even three people could undertake such a task. It required many people, talented people, people who shared the same vision and felt they wanted to do their part to make everyone else in the world realize what a great place Victoria is to make music. So we began, we wrote pages upon pages of memories and recollections. We created the roadmap, began the journey. We were joined along the way by people we had never heard of or met before. We were joined by those who had come full circle in life and wanted to bury animosities of the past and find out where their old bandmates and friends were and how they're doing. We're all joined by brilliant minds in internet, computer technology that said we can help you build it for the world to see and become a permanent record to be shared and enjoyed for generations to come. Then came the hundreds of contributors of posters, cassettes, reel-to-reel tapes, newspapers, tickets, napkins, buttons, matches, programs, and pictures. Now almost 6,000 pictures on the website, thanks to all of you and everybody else who sent them in. We say thank you all for your contributions and helping make this become a dream. So tonight we'd like to bring forward a group of individuals who through their earliest beginnings were influential in the shaping of our music culture. We're going to start off with our presenters this evening. Two of them, one is a well-respected musician, and two of them, well, they're already members of the Hall of Fame as it is already. Our first presenter is also the member of tonight's band and is a second generation Victoria musician who is being accompanied by his son, a third generation Victorian musician. His dad was Doug, he was a drummer, his name is Harry, he plays everything, and Darcy, his son, is a drummer as well. Ladies and gentlemen, Harry Creech.
Glenn's counting on my being able to read, so I'll give it a shot here. Now, as a young boy, our first inductee's love for rock and roll became an unshakable passion. He started by dancing to the music, sang the music, and then played the music. He is Victoria's original rock and roll musician. Ladies and gentlemen, our first Hall of Fame inductee for 2006, Mr. Jim Smith.
All right, next up, ladies and gentlemen, he is a founding member of Victoria's original rock and roll band, the Pharaohs, and a member of the Victoria Rock and Roll Music Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our next presenter, Mr. Ron Atfield.
First of all, Norm, he is one of the finest country musicians ever to walk among us. As a teacher, He taught many of the best guitar players to ever come from Victoria. He wouldn't play rock and roll, but he made sure his students could play their instruments correctly. Ladies and gentlemen, the inductee for most influential guitar player for 2005, Mr. Norm Windquist. In 1960, Ian began the business of owning a nightclub when he bought the Club Tango in Oak Bay from Ed Hicks. He supported local musicians by letting them both rehearse and play in his club. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's Hall of Fame inductee, Mr. Ian Diamond.
You know, I didn't do this all by myself. My wife for 45 years was beside me, all the way through the Club Tango. And Ben Anderson and Gail were with us pretty well for the 13 years that we ran the club. Frank and Heather with you were alongside us. And a lot of other people that made it all happen. Anyway, I'd like to thank you very much for this honor. Thank you.
Okay, our next group of inductees were members of a group called the Apaches. Through the late 50s and into the early 60s, these musicians caused a local frenzy wherever they played. Whether it was the opening of Town and Country Mall or kitten radio dances, this band would play music the kids wanted to hear. Okay, we'll start with the first, with two members of the band that, Glenn has not been able to locate. But let's please welcome to the Hall of Fame members of the Apaches, Gord Davies and Dwayne Cameron. Okay, also, at the end of Torquay Road in Gordon Head, a couple of young boys, with their parents' permission, started some of the city's earliest bands. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Hall of Fame, Wayne and Terry Budd. Accepting on their behalf is Sister Susan Neufeld. I was fortunate enough to play with the next two inductees, both of whom are previous Hall of Fame inductees and both deserving their second induction as members of the Apaches. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Rich England and Art Horsman. Rich England and Art Horsman. Okay, this next gentleman, he began his career in Victoria playing with some of the city's best musicians. He has been described as the coolest guy ever to pick up a guitar. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Victoria Rock and Roll Music Hall of Fame, Barry Jackson Ensign.
Just like to say a couple of words here. I'd like to thank all my peers for voting me into the Hall of Fame, all my peers that I played and worked with and knew. And I would like to also thank my family and friends who have come out to support me as far away as from Winnipeg, Vancouver, and the island, Nanaimo, Chemainus, Victoria, etc. Just a few more. Last but for sure not the least, I would like to thank Glenn Parfitt for making all this possible. And to sum it all up, as I saw in the guest book of the RCMP website, it was said there that if it wasn't for Glenn, there would be no Hall of Fame on the island. Thank you.
You said it all, Barry. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce another presenter. He is also a card-carrying member of the Victoria Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Great drummer, a friend of all, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Barry Casson.
Okay, this next inductee is a very close personal friend of mine. We go back a long, long way, all the way back to high school, as a matter of fact. He's a saxophone player like no other. Through my time as a member with the Strangers and the Canadian Strangers, we played and toured for many years, not only on the island, but also around BC and around England as well. He's a friend and now a member of the Victoria Rock and Roll Hall Music Hall of Fame. He's a real gentleman and a very good friend, and please welcome to the stage Mr. Wes Chambers. Now, our last inductee here really needs no introduction, but for those of you who haven't met her, sit back and get ready to know more about Victoria's First Lady of Rock and Roll. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll see a little bit about this from the video coming up. I think you'll all recognize Miss B.J. Cook.
Back there. All right. That's how you talk on a mic, folks. Okay, before I say anything, Glenn, I can't tell you, I'm sure everybody in this room feels the same way, but you have worked tirelessly to make this, to preserve us in the business and to honor us, and I honor you for taking the time and being in love so much with the music business and making us all feel so special. So thank you for that. I'm not going to go on and on. There are old friends, new friends. My friend Vicki Gabbro has come over to be with me. We've been pals for 40 years. And she used to come to my joints when I was singing in Vancouver and watch me put on my eyeliner and stuff. And here today we were putting on our eyeliner together. So there you go. Barry Casson, of course. I can't get into it, Barry. It's just too painful to talk about it. I sent a really nasty letter to Terry Budd telling him to get his ass here today because we needed for him to be here, but he chose not to. My cousins are here, my brother of course is here, all my girlfriends, my posse, my peeps, the people that keep me alive and keep me happy, and I made a decision a few years ago. Vicki tried to talk me into living in Vancouver. I came back. I love this island, and I'm very happy to be here. This last weekend I just spent with David. He did the David Foster Foundation, and they asked me to be part of it. And they showed that clip of me doing the thing, and the irony of all that is that baby that I'm carrying, Michael Bublé, was the star of the show. Amy wrote Michael Bublé's hit single, Home. I don't know if you all know that. So it's come full circle. It's kind of cool. I see Steve Poole down there who did that actual incredible film of me. Thank you very much. So, yeah, really cool. So I'm going to get off now because I'm starving and I've had way too much to drink. So to my friends and to my fellow musicians for the few jams that we've done, thank you so much and let's keep rocking. Thanks.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're lucky enough to get a few emails here, so we're going to read a couple of them. One to BJ. I can't think of a very many Victoria musicians any more deserving of this honor than you. It is impossible to overstate how much I learned from you about life and what it is like to be a musician. You are a true Canadian legend and one of the funniest people I've ever met. And hey, BJ, you showed me one of my favorite chords, C natural 13th with an inverted nipple. With great respect, congrats from old friend Norman McPherson. For Norm Winquist, as a kid growing up in Victoria, the first pro guitar player I heard about was you and Len. That guy in the back, Lenny Siemens. Back then it seemed that everyone who played guitar took at least some lessons from you. Long before I had a guitar of my own, I used to walk home from school with a buddy who took lessons from you. Some of my first licks were things that he showed me that he'd learned from you. As a player, as a teacher, your contribution to music in Victoria has been huge. Congratulations from another guitar playing Norm again, Norm McPherson. To all the inductees, past and present, I'd personally like to congratulate all of you today at the commemorative event. It seems like just yesterday that we were all gigging around town, sometimes working together, just sitting in or checking each other out at one of the great old Victoria venues. And now, many years later, your fine contributions are recognized to the Victoria music scene of yesteryear. My very best in regards to you all, bass player extraordinaire Brian Newcomb. This one's a little winded, but I had to do this one. Norm Winquist is a very good friend of mine who played for me every Sunday at the Esquimalt Inn Jam Sessions for the last couple of years. Being the host band, we always had to be on our toes following jammers doing songs that we'd never done. 9 times out of 10, it was Norm who led the way. We were just following. Even though it's true I hired Norm, I never felt he worked for me. Rather, I felt it an honor and a privilege to have him on the same stage, teaching me what he knew and giving me some of his experience, which, you know, Norm, came out in every note he played. Thank you very much for everything. From Missouri, Grant McIntosh. Thank you very much, Norm. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes this year's presentation, Victoria Rock and Roll Music Hall of Fame. I want to take a moment again to thank all the people that make it happen. First of all, again, our hosts, Darcy's Pump, Dale Malik, and the staff at Darcy's. Let's hear it for him. Our videographer, he's the man that makes all the magic in the movies that we watch, Mr. Steve Poole. BJ Cook, your daughter Amy had such a great name, I named one myself. To the artist who drew all the pictures, Amy Parfit. To the creator of the Jim Smith, Norm Winquist, the Apache's presentation, Darlene Lee. I want to take a minute to thank our presenters, Ron Atfield, Harry Creech, and Barry Kasson. We can't do this without sponsors and help, ladies and gentlemen, so I'll rip you through the quick list of people who throw money at this to believe in what we do. They are Alpine Transmission Auto Repair, Pacific Audio Works, LiveVictoria.com, Lazarus Productions, Concert Work Canada, producers of Victoria's Ultimate Staff Christmas Party, and DL Sound and Lighting. To all those businesses and friends, we say thank you. Stick around, ladies and gentlemen. The Essentials get ready to play another set, joined by a couple of Hall of Famers. Thank you all for attending the 2006 Victoria Rock and Roll Music Hall of Fame 2000 induction. My name's Glenn Parvin. Party on!
All the music he can make. Happy talk, keep talking, happy talk. Talk about things you like to do. You got to have a dream. If you don't have a dream, how you gonna have a dream come true? Talk about the stars.